So now we're assuming that this sample mean is one of the 98% that falls within 2.33 standard deviations of the population mean, in this case, mu sub bt. And if that's the case, then mu sub bt must be, in turn, within 2.33 standard deviations of this sample mean. So the sample mean minus 2.33 standard deviations, which is 1.01, will be our lower bound for this confidence interval. So this comes out to about 37.65. And then our upper bound for the 98% confidence interval will be 40 plus 2.33 times 1.01. So this is 42.35, approximately. So basically, we got this sample mean, 40, and we decided that it's possible that it's either here or here on the distribution, such that 1% of the data is either above it or below it. Before, with the 95% confidence interval, we said most likely it's going to be a little bit closer to the mean, so that 2.5% of the data is above it and 2.5% is below. But now we're being a little more lenient. We're allowing this sample mean to be a little bit further from the population mean. And so now we have a slightly bigger interval. But now we're more sure that the true population mean will be in this interval. Recall that before, the 95% confidence interval was from 38.01 to 41.99, so it was a little smaller than this. Good job!